I wanted to just sort of start out before I introduce the panel with a quick framing of the issue and emphasize that the topic tonight is not overuse of testing, it's appropriate use, and that's a reason. There's a reason for that. Certainly as I read the professional literature and the popular literature, I'm bombarded with information about over-testing, about too much testing, about the cost of testing. One of the slides you showed was from a report by John Eaglehart in 2007 that said the cost of imaging is growing 17% per year for the last 6 years. And people are focused on that very, very large number. It is growing extremely fast, the cost. In fact, that is the largest growth area of any part of medical services. But to focus only on the cost is, I think, shortchanging the patient. There's no question that if we were to eliminate all imaging, all laboratory tests, all pathology, we could take the portion of the national health expenditure that's devoted to testing down to zero. And you wouldn't, what you would see are things like length of stay go up, but you wouldn't be able to call it associated with testing. You'd see inappropriate antibiotic use go up. You would see unnecessary procedures, cardiac cath and other things go up. So when we focus only on the cost line, we are really only partially discussing the question. And most of the literature has been on volume and cost. It's very hard to find anything on underuse, and yet that is certainly what has to be balanced in this discussion. And I think as we go through the discussion tonight, we'll try to get more of that in play. There's no question that there's some low-hanging fruit. There's no question there's duplicate testing, redundant testing, unnecessary testing. I think the issue in my mind is how do we not get focused solely on the cost issue and really look at the bigger picture of appropriateness. How are patient care and outcomes affected by inappropriate testing, whether it is the ordering of an unnecessary test or, and this is the part that's important, the failure to order a necessary test? And what effect does this have on the rate of diagnostic error? Rob?
Well, you know, first of all, it's a pleasure to be a part of this, and I commend you guys for really trying to bring more light onto this very important subject. I think that the issue of appropriate testing is really a complex, multifaceted one. When we look at some of these unnecessary tests, I think there's a subset of these that really don't affect the patient outcomes at all, and I think that's really part of the issue. What it does is it adds inconvenience, it adds stress, it adds cost without really a clear benefit. And so one example of that might be something like a stress test in a low-risk person without any symptoms at all. So they'll go through the procedure and a lot of times not really get any benefit out of it. There's another subset, though, that where this unnecessary testing may lead to subsequent issues downstream. You know, if that same stress test, for example, ends up with a false positive test, and the patient then undergoes a more invasive cardiac procedure, and then if that procedure has complications, then clearly I think patient outcomes have been affected by the unnecessary test. So I think that really is something, these sort of complications from the results of tests that didn't need to be ordered in the first place, and the reaction to false positive tests can absolutely increase the rate of diagnostic errors. And like you said, we have to balance out that with our failure to order necessary tests. And on that side, clearly that is going to be related to diagnostic errors. These necessary tests, by not ordering them, we're going to be delaying the real diagnosis, the identification anyway of the real diagnosis. which can lead to delays in treatment and potentially harm patient outcomes as well. You know, one could argue whether the failure to order a necessary test is the cause or the result of a diagnostic error, but either way, it's an important issue that we have to address.
Okay, great. Thanks, Rob. I've got a number of things your comments have already prompted in my mind, but we'll go through the other two first and then maybe come back if we have time. So, Mimi, I'd love to hear your response.
Well, inappropriate testing is wasteful because in either case of ordering unnecessary tests or the failure to order a necessary test, the result is wasted time, which results in delays in diagnosis and or failure to diagnose, and wasted work such as telephone calls to coordinate the testing or scheduling of visits, wasted patient travel, transportation costs to get the unnecessary tests done, unnecessary pain experienced by patients. After all, who likes to have their blood drawn or an IV placed, especially unnecessarily, of course. So added cost of testing without any added value, lost days of work or school or productivity by patients are also results from this. Therefore, in summary, really the outcome of inappropriate testing includes delays or failures in diagnosis, translating into increased lengths of stay for inpatients, patient and staff dissatisfaction and frustration due to the usual inefficiencies in scheduling, coordination of tests and visits. Again, valueless pain and suffering, added costs without any benefit, lost wages and productivity, as well as increased out-of-pocket costs, travel and transportation for outpatient testing. So it's really valueless effort and work. Thank you.
Thanks, Mimi. Adam, it's hard to be third, give it a shot.
Sure. You know, I just to, obviously everyone is, what they've said is 100% correct. I think, you know, we have to start, you know, fundamentally and look at why do we order tests? What's the reason for ordering tests? And usually it's obviously to get information. And obviously, usually it's to find out sort of what's wrong with a patient or possibly to monitor the patient's progress or whether positively or negatively. And we have to sort of educate the physicians and other healthcare providers as to what tests to use and when to use them. Because I think that when you're ordering a test that's either not going to get the information that you need or is going to get information that you don't need, then you're just, again, wasting time, but you also may either get the wrong diagnosis, delay the diagnosis, start yourself down a path of sort of diagnosing problems that may not have anything to do with why the patient initially came into that, you know, came to the physician's office or came to the emergency department, or depending on, you know, whatever the individual situation is. So I think that, you know, ordering inappropriate testing basically is, you know, not allowing that physician and therefore that patient to get the answers they need. I think that's sort of just like a fundamental sort of disconnect that we're seeing, I think, you know, not all the time, but I think far too often.
So just a very quick follow-up on this before we move to the next question, just to you, Adam. So clearly in clinical laboratories, which is where I spend most of my life, the impact of an inappropriate test, there's been very little written about it. The cascade effect that Rob talked about leading to other kinds of efforts is something that's not described very often in the literature. It's assumed, but it's not really described. In radiology and in the fields that you're probably more familiar with, it would seem that would be much more likely to drive additional action, and that cascade effect could be very problematic. Is that true, or?
Absolutely. I mean, I was talking to Eric Glazer about this today about a specific situation, but you know, it does two things. Yes, it can you know, sort of, there's all this data that people used to studies on, you know, when patients came into the emergency department and had a CT scan for appendicitis, and then all the sort of side diagnoses that were made off that initial scan, and then sort of, you know, how much additional imaging or additional testing was generated off a CT scan for appendicitis, which may or may not have been necessary. But so it does two things. Yes, it can lead you down sort of the wrong path or lead you down an unnecessary tangent. But at the same time, maybe more importantly, is it may not be providing you the information that you need. I think that's more important. So yes, we have all sorts, everybody knows the situation of sort of the stress test leading to the cardiac cath, leading to the, you know, the retroperitoneal hematoma that caused the patient to get a blood transfusion and blah, blah, blah. But the more important thing is, while we were wasting our time with this sort of stress test for the heart problem that the patient didn't have, we may have been failing to diagnose sort of gastroesophageal reflux or, you know, some other problem that we just didn't diagnose because we sort of got let off by an inappropriate test.
Okay, great. Thank you.